بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. معصية كاذبة خادعة. My dear respectful brothers and sisters, today the topic of this Friday sermon is an issue which is known to everybody. Every one of us knows this topic, maybe more than I know, or better than how I describe and explain. So not only it is not only we Muslims or we our congregation who knows it better, but every human being knows this topic very well. A child who is even 0 years old knows this one. But still, we have to mention it. Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, فَذَكِّرْ إِنَّ فَعَتِ الذِّكْرَى. Just remind them, because reminding can help those who are تَنْفَعُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. It will help those the believers. And also, not only that, Allah the Almighty has mentioned this issue in the Quran very frequently. Thousands of verses in the Quran mentioned in different ways. So the topic is about lying, to lie. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala teaches us the consequence of lying. In many ways, in different ways to understand. One time he tells us about lying, and again he tells us about the opposite word of lying. When he warns us from lying, then he also reminds us the goodness and the virtues of being truthful. So because of that, you can see the significance of lying and not lying, the importance of not lying, and the very bad consequence of lying. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, in Surah Al-Araf, Allah is telling us about those who will enter the hellfire. And Allah says, نَاسِيَةٍ كَاذِبَةٍ خَادِعَةٍ. It is the forerunner. The forerunner is this hair on top of everybody, has some hairs on their forehead. So this hair, نَاسِيَةٍ كَاذِبَةٍ خَادِعَةٍ. Allah says, we will drag their forerunners like this way, and this nasiya for Lord is kadibatin, is the one that lies. The liar for Lord and the sinful for Lord. And then Allah says, let him call anyone that he is expecting to help him. And then we will call Zabaniya, that hellfire. So we can see what leads someone to hellfire. One of the main leaders to hellfire is the liar, is lying. Somebody to become a liar, that person must prepare his or her position in the hellfire. It's very clear. That is why it is something which every person knows, all human beings can understand and can comprehend it well. But at the same time, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us from time to time. And that liar, a liar is that person who is, that everybody knows how it is, first of all, shameful, it is destructive, it is all kinds of destruction in this world and hereafter. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in Surah Al-Najm, وَكَذَّبُوا وَتَوَعُوا أَهْوَاهُمْ. That's Surah Al-Tarbat Sa'a, وَنْشَقَ الْقَمَرِ. وَيَّرُوا آيَةَ الْبُعُدُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَكَذَّبُوا وَتَوَعُوا أَهْوَاهُمْ. And they lied. When we showed them our verses, then they lied and they followed their desires. They followed their lusts. They followed their lands, their desires, and their what they love. That is what they followed. Even though they see the truth, they didn't accept it. So they followed their desires. When somebody follows his or her desires, then what comes is that what comes can be called a compulsive lying. That person would lie in any way because they want to satisfy themselves. So when you want to satisfy yourself in any way possible, you have no choice but to lie. But that means always those who lie, they are. It comes in two conditions. One of them is that you are in fear, and the other one is that you are in need. So the major problem is that when you are in need of something, because need never lasts. You will still need something. Even if you are given the whole world, you will need some more. That is if you do not control your desires. So to control your desires, you need to control your egos. And to kill your ego, that is when you are successful to control your life, to control your desires, to control who you are, and you know yourself, and you can practice in a better way that is helpful for your life in this world and hereafter. But if your ego controls, then you are in a strait, you are in loss, and no doubt that you will lose in every action you will take. In many teachings, I have read that in the Buddhas, they teach two things. One thing, first of all, in the beginning, is to say that there are always mystery and sadness in this world. There are many things which are obscure that you cannot understand and difficult, and at the same time there will be sadness. But you cannot succeed until you kill the mystery and sadness. And then you cannot kill the mystery and sadness until you kill the desires. So you kill your desires, then you kill the egos. But if you don't kill your desires will guide you and will force you to lie in a compulsive way that you feel you have no choice but to lie. And when you reach a bad situation, it's when you are under control by your ego, so you don't belong to yourself, you are owned by your ego. You are a tool, an instrument owned by the ego that's in you, a satanic one. So you are in that instrument. And all you think about is to say, mine, my things, mine, me, I, and who is talking about me, what do they say about me, what do I have now, what will I have, how can I get this one? So you are in this dilemma, in this confusion, in this situation which is terrible life. That's in the world. And you will try to attract others, to convince other people that you are a nice person by lying, but lying that will not lead you other than the opposite of what you are looking for. You will be undermined. You will be someone who is disgusted. You will be deceptible, and you will be someone who is considered as deceiving person. So that is the lie. That is the road that lie will take you to. It will take you to that road, which is nothing, which is a dark place, empty place. But if you control your ego and you kill your ego, and at the same time you know that lying is destructive to you, that is when you turn on your light in the tunnel and you can see everything very clearly. And that comes when you know what you owe, what you is your property and what you need. Unless you limit your satisfaction, you cannot feel that position. That is a stage. To control your ego is when you control your wants, your needs, your requirements, and you know your limitation. You must know that you are only one person in this world, and there are billions and billions in this world, and everything on the face of the earth is owned by Allah. So all your property is only what you eat that night, that's it. Then you limit your satisfaction, you know what you are, and you will not need to lie. In that situation, you will not need to lie. But if you still need more, then you will still need to lie and to cram after everything and to go like a crazy person. And in that situation, you are not normal. You are unhealthy. You are in disease. And that's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned in the Quran by saying, بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم في قلوبهم مرض فزادهم الله مرضا ولهم عذاب أليم بما كانوا يكذبون. In their heart is there's a disease, and Allah increases their disease in them, because they will deserve the torment life because of that they lie. Bima kanu yakthibun, because of their lies, because they have been lying, then that is what they deserve. And when you lie, you will be banished in this world. How will you be banished in this world? Because you will go crazy. You will become crazy in the world. So you are already in hellfire. Because you can't control yourself, and then you will start lying to yourself. When you lie to yourself, you lie to your spouse, you lie to your kids, you lie to your friends, your family, and everybody. And when you lie to everybody, everybody will consider you as someone who is deceiver, someone who is destructive, and everybody will distance himself from you, and you will be isolated, and people will consider you as a crazy person. So you are already in the beginning of that empire. That is why lying is the one of the major destructives. And when you lie, when you follow your desires, what happens is that you will become munafiq, hypocrites. You will act hypocritically in every action. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has already mentioned that hypocrites are also liars. When Allah says, إِنَّ الْمُنَافِقُونَ لَكَاذِبُونَ, indeed, the hypocrites, people, are also liars. And إِنَّ الْمُنَافِقُونَ فِي دَرْكٍ أَسْفَلِ مِنَ النَّارِ, and the hypocrites will be dwelling in the lowest and the worst class of the hellfire. So when you confess yourself that this lie is true, and that's when you will start to lie, as mostly happens, that somebody knows that he or she is lying, and they will strengthen their lie with swearing by Allah, saying, but in the name of Allah, this is true. And in the name of Allah, this is so and so. Then they did double of problems. They have created many, many problems from there. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in the Quran about the consequence of being like that situation, where Allah says, وَيَحْلِفُونَ بِاللَّهِ عَلَى الْكَذِبِ وَهُمْ يَعْلَمُونَ. And imagine to the level where they will reach at the level where they swear in the name of Allah why they are lying, and they know they are lying. So that situation is the one which is disruptive to your life, to the life of your people in this world and hereafter. But at the same time, it is something which everybody knows, and it is written in every religion, be it Muslim, and any religion, in Islam, Christianity, Judaism, Hinduism, Buddhism, Confucianism, Taoism, all of them, they lie about that. The minimum is taught not to lie. Therefore, this lie, can we control our ego and limit our satisfactions and our needs so that we will not need to lie, and so that we can become upright, we can become straightforward, otherwise we will be from doers and liars. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. My dear respectful brothers and sisters, Allah سبحانه وتعالى says, ويقولون على الله الكذب وهم يعلمون. And they would say something about Allah, which is not true, which is lie, even though they know. In another verse, Allah says, "What unknowingly." So you talk about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knowingly and unknowingly while you are not telling the truth but lying. So lying can be divided into many ways. You might lie against Allah, you might lie against the creator, you might lie to yourself, you might lie to your co-workers, you might lie to your spouses, I'm sorry. Or you might create lie and falsifications and spread it around. Or you might, it comes mainly in two ways. One is called exaggeration and the other one is speculation. You create something, you have perception in your mind, and you believe, you make judgment. You say, this one, okay, I know it is that, don't worry, it's already that. I understand. So you make your own decision, but it is based on lies. That lie is the one you lie to yourself, and you confess to yourself, but you believe it is true. So then you lie, and you make the judgment, and you go ahead and you start working on it. That is one way it is as a result of speculation. Or you see somebody and you already, you become judgmental. You know this person is such and such things. So this is one kind of lie. The other lie is exaggeration. That you see something, it has a limit of badness. It has a limit of wrong things. But you exaggerate, you put it into the worst situation. Or something, it has kind of good things in it, but you made it the best, like a product. You said, this is the best. So always you must be in the limit, so that you will not create problem. And the other time is when you hear something, and immediately you say, this is what it is. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِنْ جَاءَكُمْ فَاسِقٌ بِنَبَإٍ فَتَبَيَّنُوا أَنْ تُصِيبُوا قَوْمًا بِجَهَالَةٍ. Or you who believe in Allah, the Almighty. If somebody comes to you, who is a fasiq, a transgressor, or anybody comes to you to tell you news, فَتَبَيَّنُوا, verify that news, whether it is true or not. Somebody is talking about someone, and then he said, this person is such and such things. You must verify that this is true, whether it is true or not. Only after that, you make your decision. You should not be in a hurry. That is another way of lying. So lying is taking in perception that you already have in your mind. And the other one is speculation. The other one is, and you already have something and you believe it and you start doing it. The other way is that you talk about a lie in a wrong way, which is not true. Or you tell about Islam wrongly. Or those things. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, it's enough for someone to lie to tell whatever he hears. So whatever you hear, you say that is enough for you to become a liar. And Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, somebody will keep lying until he is registered in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he is a liar. And again another hadith, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, إِنَّ الْكَلْبُ يَعْدِي إِلَى الْفُجُورِ وَإِنَّ الْفُجُورِ يَعْدِي إِلَى اللَّهِ. So the lying would lead you to the fujur, to become fajr, someone who is transgressed. And that one would lead you to hellfire. So, and it is in the same verse that I have recited, the verse that إِنَّ الْمَافِقُونَ الْكَافِقُونَ. So the hypocrites are liars. This hadith says there are three signs, three categories, three characteristics can show you are the mad person. One of them is that if he is giving you conversation, he lies in his conversations or her conversations. So that one is a liar. And then another type of a lie of lying is that somebody is right in front of you, the worst one. Is you are telling to that person or you are talking about that person in a way which is not true, right in the face of that person, and you are forcing that person even to accept that lie. That is called buhtan in the Quran. Quran calls it buhtan, and it is the worst situation. It is this one where and some people, especially it comes also in the religion, that somebody, when he says something, this is halal or haram, why he doesn't know whether it's halal or haram, or he knows but he is intentionally lying. Allah says, لِمَا تَصِفُ أَلْسِنَةُ الْكَذِبَ هَذَا حَلَالٌ وَهَذَا حَرَامٌ. And there are times the greatest or beautifies for them to say this is halal, this is permissible, and this is haram, this is impermissible. So they just say, because their time shows them it's good to say that. That person is lying in the face of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And another one lies in the face of somebody by saying, it's from the iftira that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَا إِذْ سَمِعْتُمُونَ ظَنَّ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ بِأَنفُسِهِمْ خَيْرًا وَقَالُوا هَذَا إِفْكٌ مُبِينٌ. And what about if you hear the Muslims, the believers, who say among themselves, they say good to each other, and when they hear something bad and lies, when they hear false statements, they say, "Hada ifkun mubin." This is definitely it is a clear lie. And then in another verse, they will say, Subhanaka hada buhtan alim. Your excellent Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is very clear obstruction of lies. So this lie is very sincere, very, very serious, very serious, and you cannot become sincere until you kill the lies. And you can't kill the lies until you kill their ego, and you can't kill your ego until you limit your satisfaction, you know what you need for your body. And that is where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala curses the liars in Surah Al-Dariyat, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, قُتِلَ الْخَرَّاسُونَ. Cursed be the liars. The liars are cursed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the liars are cursed in all the religions and all even the common senses and the sacred traditions, brothers and sisters, I advise myself and to yourself that we stay away from lying and try our best not to make lying to Abu Salat.
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله عليه الصلاة